In this video, I'll show how to backtest the robot once you download it. Copy the expert advisor according to MetaTrader 4 or MetaTrader 5. I'll be using MetaTrader 4 for the purpose of this video, and I'm recording while I'm using version 4 of the expert advisor where the filter is on M30. Then I'll go to file, open data folder, MQL4 experts, and I will paste the expert advisor. It is already in the folder, so I'll just replace it. I'll close the folder, I will right click over expert advisors and hit on refresh. I already have it in my navigator and I can drag and drop it on the chart. It is the one called Filter M30 version 4, and I will drag it over the chart. I don't need to enable the auto trading because I just want to backtest it. Here are all of the inputs and I will click on OK. Now the expert is attached and I can backtest it. I have an FTMO trial account with $200,000. And if I right click over the chart and go to expert advisors and hit on strategy tester, you will see the tester. Now there are a few reasons why you may not see any trades opening on the backtest. This is usually if you are testing on $10,000 with huge lot, like six lots, because I use six lots for the 200K challenges. That is why you make sure to increase the initial deposit for the backtest, or you can stick to 10,000, but from inputs, make sure to lower the lot size to 0.3, for example, and same thing on the maximum position amount. However, I will stick to six lots for the purpose of the video, and I will increase the initial deposit again to $200,000, and I will click on OK. The next thing is, if you have just installed the MetaTrader from FTMO, probably you will not see a lot of bars, and we need this historical data to perform the backtest. You can press the home key on your keyboard, but you can see that the maximum I get is the 30th of May, and today we are 1st of August, so it's just 2 months. And the same thing if I show you one of my VPSs where I have a funded FTMO account. If I press the home key on M1, you will see that I go back to the 29th of May. So that's not really enough. That is why I will go to my account at yatradingacademy.com and I will go to historical data app. And here I will set the maximum bars I want to use, the time zone, and I will load data for euro dollar in the format of MetaTrader. Then I will download this historical data. It is free to download the data, and I will import it on MetaTrader. If I open the CSV file, you will see how it looks like. There is information for all the bars from the moment until the 17th of January 2023, which is about 6 months, and it's more than enough to backtest the expert advisor. And then what you need to do is go to Tools, History Center, and I will find Euro Dollar, and I will click on M1. I will click on the first bar, I will click on Control and Shift, scroll to the bottom, and tap on the last one. This will mark all of the data, and I will delete it. Now I will import the data that I have downloaded. Right over here is the file for Euro Dollar on M1. I will open it and I will click on OK. Now I have much more data. You can see back from January 2023. And this is a reliable historical data without gaps and any issues. And I will do the very same thing for M30, because the expert advisor uses historical data, hard time frame filter on M30, especially the version 4. I will first delete it, and then I will import the file that I downloaded for Euro Dollar M30. And I will click on OK, and you will see that the chart loaded. Now, whenever you're watching this video and you want to see if the expert advisor will pass a challenge or how it performed, you can set the dates. Let's say, for example, you're watching that video in mid-March 2023 and you want to see how it performed for the last 1 month or the last 1.5 months. So backtest is from the beginning of February 2023 until mid-March 2023. I will set spread. Currently, it's about 2-3 points, but for more conservative testing, I will stick to 10 points or 1 pip. Make sure you're on the right asset. One more time, go through the expert properties to ensure you have enough initial deposit according to the lots you will be trading and hit on start. You will see the backtest with the graph and the result. If you have enough historical data, there is no reason for the backtest not to perform or at least open trades. And once the backtest is ready, you will see in the report the result. So it made nearly $40,000, or that is about 20%. And for 1.5 months, it is enough to pass a challenge actually twice. And one more time, this is a test with $200,000. Trading with 6 lots. It is up to you with how much you will be trading or backtesting, but make sure you have enough margin to open trades and you have enough historical data on your chart. However, keep in mind that the backtest on MetaTrader is not very precise, especially when we use hard time frame filters. Like in this version of the robot, I use MACD to be higher than the signal line on M30, and the main time frame is the envelopes on M1. And unfortunately, the backtester on MetaTrader is not the most reliable one when there is hard time frame filters, and that is why what you can do as well is to import back the expert advisor in FSB Pro. There is a free version, so whenever you're watching that video or testing the robot, you can just import the current version in FSB. The historical data is automatically uploaded from the premium data we use, and you will see a very precise backtest. You can check out as well the indicator chart and see exactly where we have short trade and then where we have long trades. Or if you want to modify the expert advisor, you can do that. No programming is needed, and you can export it with one click as an expert advisor for MetaTrader 4 or MetaTrader 5. However, you can backtest the robot just as I showed to you on MetaTrader, but make sure you have enough historical data on the chart for M1 and M30, because these are the two time frames the robot uses. And make sure you have appropriate lot according to the account size you are trading.